Testing, is this working? I hope so. All right. So, as you can see, this weekend, technically it's still running for like 50 minutes. We had the Game Makers Toolkit Game Jam 2018. For those of you that don't know, Game Makers Toolkit is a YouTube channel by Mark Brown, former, I believe, GameSpot writer, who does very informative YouTube videos about game design. I really recommend everybody to check it out. It's great stuff that he does. And this is now his second game jam that he's hosting. And as you can see, it's got a lot of entries. We have 3,200 people. And at this point, there have been over 590 submissions. And considering there's like 50 minutes left, I highly assume that there's going to be a lot more games. Now, me myself, I actually participated in this game jam. It was 48 hours, starting on... technically, it was the September the 1st at midnight. But due to time zone, it was actually on August 31st for me on like 11 p.m. And it lasted for 48 hours. And the theme of this game jam was, what's it called? Game mechanic. Wait, where is it? Genre, but you can't mechanic. So this theme is, as all of his game jam themes, which there's a total of two, it's actually based around a video that he made. And this theme is based around the video he made about Snake Pass and how Snake Pass is a platformer without your jumping. And that inspired him for the theme. So the theme is to make a game in a genre and take something away from that genre. Now, this is a really tough theme, if you ask me, because taking away something that is essential for that genre, which is something that you should do in the theme, oftentimes just removes the genre, right? So if you remove jumping from the platforming genre, is it then still a platformer? I don't know. So I had a really hard time coming up with a game idea for this theme, and the game I came up with was a platformer, which is like super, super uninspired, I know. It's a platformer where you can't see yourself. The game ended up being more of a, I don't know, stealthy puzzle platformer, so the platforming isn't really the super focus of this game, but yeah, that's what I ended up with. And technically, sometimes you can see yourself, even though not very often, and usually when you can see yourself, it's not very good for you. So, as you can see, the game was made in Unity, and I had some assistance of a... an artist that I met on the Discord. Her name is Phenomenon, and she made really nice art assets for this game. So let's just start the game and run it and see how it looks. All right. So there's the game. As you can see, it's called Veer, which is a very fitting name for a title where you can't see yourself. So, yeah, controls are pretty simple. You use the WSD to move, space to jump, and control. So, yeah, let's just get started. Now, this is the first level, and as you can see, there is, like, enemies. There's this guy here, there's this turret, but you can't see yourself. And that's, like, as I said, the focus of this game. So when I jump, you see this little smoke puffs, which indicate where you are. So this is like one little helper to show you where you are. Then you have audio cues that you can hear, footsteps that show you. You can't really hear where you are, but you can at least hear that you are actually moving. Same when jumping. There's this jump sound. I don't know if you hear it. Okay, so the goal of the game pretty much is to traverse all three levels. Yeah, there's actually three levels. It's not that much, but it's actually really hard to come up with a good level design for a game like this. And I'm not really claiming that this level design is good, but it's something. So yeah, let's show you how it works, shall we? All right, if I go all the way to the right, you can see this little message appears, which pops up when you get near a door. These things you can see here are doors which will which are usable, and then they will just teleport you to another position. Now, as you can see, there's two routes for me to take. The left one is where this tower is. It's the shorter one, and then there's this right one, which leads me to the door. Now, as you can see, there's this light on the ceiling, and if I get into this light, I'm actually getting visible, but also the enemies can see me, and as soon as the enemy can see me, then I'm in rage. They will shoot me, and every attack of the enemy will instantly kill me, so yeah. There's not really much of a chance to recover from the situations. You can avoid the shots, but yeah, that's a little bit more advanced. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use this door, and now I'm taking the route to the right, which is the safe route. Take this door, now I'm here, as you can see when I jump. And now there's this light again, which would review me. And when I get reviewed, the guy would shoot me, so I will have to wait until it turns off, and then I can run through it. Now I reach the door, and the red arrow is the exit. Now this is the second level. As you can see, there's a light on the top which reveals me, and I actually apparently just found a bug where I can jump through walls. That's not what I expected. Okay. This is, yeah, that's Game Gems for you, right? So, let's restart this really quick. Fortunately, I built a little shortcut into the game, so I can skip levels. I'm not telling you how it works, but I can tell you it's not very sophisticated. So, level 2 again. You can see there's this light on the top, which reveals me, but it won't reveal me all the time. It will only review me for like 2 seconds, which in this case actually is long enough to see me all the way, so it's not really that challenging. It's maybe a little bit undertuned. I tweaked around the values around quite a bit. Why is there no collider on this wall? That's really weird. You can see it's quite bugged, right? It's a game jam. It's stuff that happens. Now if I drop into this bottomless pit here, as you can see here, I will die, but fortunately the game will just restart the level. So yeah, let's just jump over this edge and go to this door to our next level. Now I'm starting over here, and as you can see, this level gets a little bit more complicated. It's still not really sophisticated, but yeah, it's a little bit more to think about. Now there's multiple routes you can take, and as you can see, if you drop down this hole, it's probably going to end deadly for us, because there's this turret to the left, and then this guy to the right, which will probably shoot us. So what I'm going to try, and this is actually really tricky, because you can't see really much, and you can see it didn't work. Now, I fortunately made it past the guard. I think there's a bug with the guards right now that they don't attack. I'm not entirely sure. Now, as you can see, it now dropped me down to this door, which actually is the fastest way through the level. You can take the road over here. I don't know if you can actually see my mouse cursor. Then you will... then you will actually... I think you will land here. Let's just try both roads. I'm actually... I don't know exactly. Now, as you can see, those guys, they run to you. Now, there's obviously a bug. They don't attack. Normally, they will shoot at me. So, yeah, that's something I might... fix before the gem actually ends. And yeah, they only follow me if they see me, so that's like the how the mechanic works. They only see me if you're actually visible, right? And there's this flickering light, so it will only reveal you if it's actually visible. So yeah, that's something to work around. Now, unfortunately, we don't have animated characters, which is a shame, because I think the art itself looks pretty neat. It's simple, but it has a great vibe, and yeah. As I mentioned, there are only three levels, so this is the last one. If I go through this door, you will actually end up at the end screen, and that's pretty much the whole game. So, yeah. That's real for you guys. It's my GMTK Game Jam submission. The artist, known as Phenomenon, did a phenomenal job, if you ask me. It was great pleasure to work with her, and yeah, I hope you guys like the game, and I will post the link to the game jam and the game itself in the description below, and we might actually keep working on this, because I think it has a lot of potential to actually become a really great game. So yeah, I'll keep you updated about that. See ya, guys.